online, I saw this, and I'm not saying it, but people are saying that Balderas should come train with you. Have you heard that?
Look,
he's a great fighter, Olympian, and he got stopped this weekend.
You know, it's not because he got knocked out. That's not the reason. I wouldn't take him. You know, every time I see him in at different fights, he's very respectful kid, very, you know, very humble to me. His uncle and his dad are very respectful. But I had never, you know, I had never really paid attention to any of his interviews or any of conversations he's had with other reporters. And there's some things that I think he should have stayed quiet when talking about, you know, I'm the face of boxing now, which, you know, come on, you're not, you know, he's still not there, you know. I don't think, you know, talking about Teofimo the way he was talking, I think he should have never talked about Teofimo like that, because look at Teofimo, he's a world champion now. And look at what Teofimo could say. Look, you just got knocked out against somebody that you should have beat. I think he just stayed a little more. Okay, seis.
What's up?
Should have stayed a little more quiet. I never seen those interviews, but when I'm watching those interviews, I think, you know, experience. You know, he doesn't have experience. His uncle, his dad, you know, A-plus level, no hype needed, you know, stuff like that. It's a little unexperienced, you know, stay quiet, you know, don't compare yourself to Teofimo. Teofimo's on a different level, let's just be real. Teofimo's a world champion now. Three, four, five fights back, Teofimo was already making noise. Everybody was talking about him already. So don't compare yourself to Teofimo, especially when you know that guy's doing really good and you're not even, your fights are not even televised. Your promoter's not, he's not promoting you the way he should. You know, I'm just being honest. Hey, maybe one day we'll meet. That's what he should have been saying. Man, I would love to fight him. We already have beef from the amateurs. Maybe one day we could meet and fight against each other. Maybe I feel like I could beat him. But, you know, the way he would come on interviews, it was just the wrong way, I think. You know, Canelo doesn't even speak English, you know. I think he said in one interview, oh no, I'm the face of boxing. Canelo doesn't even speak English. Doesn't matter if Canelo don't speak English. Canelo's the man in boxing right now. Canelo's the, you know.
Fight of the year by ESPN and Eddie Reynoso, trainer of the year, Robert.
100%, I agree. 100%. Trainer of the year and fight of the year, 100%. There's nobody else. They can't give it to nobody else. It's him, you know, it's them. So, you know, little things like that should have kept them a little more quiet and maybe say, you know what, one day I want to fight him. Yeah, you know, I think it's going to be a good fight. Stuff like that. You know, it's learning experience for them. I think he'll bounce back. He's very, very, very good fighter, very good boxer. You know, one thing is, they better stop wearing those fucking underwear. The underwear they get for free, that's bad luck, guys. All those guys that get free underwear, stop fucking using that shit. It's happened. Look at all the fighters lately. Regis. What's Maidana's brother's name?
Fabian.
Now this kid right here. Stop wearing those fucking underwear.
I wanted to ask you, Robert. Obviously, Neno's here training. Does he have a fight date?
It looks like maybe February 28th.
February 28th?
In Dallas?
Yeah. The night before Mikey?
Yes. Yeah, we're putting up a card over there the night before. So it'll be Neno, the kids from Dallas, Gaitan, the Alejandro brothers. Maybe, I think B-Fly might be on that card again.
B-Fly had a big knockout, Robert. Congratulations to B-Fly.
That's good. Biggie's going to fight on that card the night before Mikey. Then on Mikey's card, what's his name? Espino. Alex Espino is going to be on that card. And I think we have Murataya or somebody else. But we might have somebody else on the card.
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram at Elie Seckbach. Take a step back. Elie Seckbach.